Hello students, welcome to Vidya Virat. Today I have come with class 9 chapter number 8 quadrilaterals and we are going to do exercise 8.1 of NCERT. Question number 1. The angles of quadrilateral are in the ratio of 3:5:9:13. Find all the angles of the quadrilaterals. Now to begin with this question, we know that the sum of the angles of the quadrilateral is 360 degrees. So we can assume all the angles as 3x, 5x, 9x and 13x. We can find out the value of x, which comes out to be 12 degrees. Put it into 3x, 5x, 9x and 13x. You got the required angles as 36 degrees, 60 degrees, 108 and 156 degrees. Question number 2. If the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, then show that it is a rectangle. Now here first of all let us write down that ABCD is a parallelogram and in the parallelogram they are told that diagonals are equal. That means AC is equal to BD. Now in this we need to prove that ABCD is a rectangle. So to prove rectangle, it should be that any one of the angle we can prove it as 90 degrees, then it will become as rectangle. Now in triangle ABC and triangle DCB, the shaded color, if you see, just focus there and let us try to make these two triangles congruent. Now here we have AC is equal to DB, which is already given to us. AB will be equal to DC, we know, because opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal, and BC is equal to CB, which is common. So by SSS criteria we can say that both the triangles are congruent, and when the triangles are congruent we can also say that angle ABC is equal to angle DCB by CBCD. Now consider the line AB and CD, they both are parallel because it is a parallelogram, and BC is your transversal. Considering this, we can say that angle ABC plus angle DCB will be equal to 180 degrees because these are co-interior angles, but they both angles are equal, so we can say that each angle is 90 degrees. Since each angle is 90 degrees, we can say that ABCD is a rectangle. Question number 3. Show that if the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other at right angles, then it is a rhombus. Now what do we need to prove in rhombus? Adjacent sides should be equal. And what is given to us? ABCD is a quadrilateral and the diagonals bisect means AO is equal to OC and OB is equal to OD, and also the center angles are 90 degrees. We need to prove that ABCD is a rhombus, so we will prove all the sides equal. Let us take the two adjacent triangles AOB and triangle AOD. AO and OA is common there, and OB is equal to OD because they bisect each other, and angle AOB is equal to angle AOD, which is 90 degrees because they are bisecting at right angles. So we can say that by SAS criteria the both the triangles are congruent, and hence we can say by CPCT that AB is equal to AD. Similarly we can prove all others, and we can say that AB is equal to BC, BC is equal to CD and CD is equal to DA. Since all the sides are equal, we can say that ABCD is a rhombus. Next, show that the diagonals of a square are equal and bisect each other at right angles. Now here what is given to us? ABCD is a square. What does it mean? Square means its all the sides will be equal and it is a parallelogram. And all the angles A, B, C, D, that will be 90 degrees. What we need to prove? They are saying diagonals of a square are equal. The first criteria we will prove it, AC is equal to DB. Then they are also saying diagonals bisect each other. That means OA should be equal to OC and OB is equal to OD. And at last they are saying they are bisecting at right angles. That means inside angles should be also 90 degrees. So let's begin by proving the first part, AC is equal to BD. Now here we are going to take the big two triangles, the yellow color. If you see, we will just focus there. We are taking the triangle ABC and triangle BAD. In this, you know that AB is equal to BA, it is common. BC is equal to AD, that is sides of the square. And the angle ABC will be equal to angle BAD, which each angle is 90 degrees. So inner square we have already discussed and it is given. So we can say that triangles are congruent. Since the triangles are congruent, we can say that AC is equal to BD by CPCT. They are the parts of the congruent triangles. Now let us prove that the diagonals bisect each other, that is OA is equal to OC and OB is equal to OD. So in that case, we will be taking two opposite triangles. So triangle AOD and triangle OCB, we will just focus over here. Now before that, we know that AD is parallel to BC and AC as a transversal, if we take it, then in that case we know that angle 1 is equal to angle 3, alternate interior angles of a parallelogram. And similarly, we can also say that angle 2 is equal to angle 4. Considering this, we will try to make these two triangles congruent. Now we have AD is equal to CB, sides of a square are equal. We have angle 1 is equal to angle 3, angle 2 is equal to angle 4, they are the alternate interior angles. So by ASA criteria, we say that triangles are congruent. And when the triangles are congruent, by CPCT, we can also say that OA is equal to OC and OD is equal to OB, which means diagonals bisect each other at O. Next, third, diagonals bisect each other at right angles. Right angles means inside angle or the O. Angles formed should be 90 degrees. So we have taken two adjacent triangles. The blue part we will focus over there. We are taking triangles OBA and triangle ODA. Now here what we do is we have OB is equal to OD. We have just proved above. BA is equal to DA. These are the sides of a square. So all the sides are equal. And OA is equal to OA, which is common. So by CPCT, we can say that the angles formed in the interior, that is angle AOB, is equal to angle AOD. So angles are equal, but they should be 90 degrees. Now what is it basically? AOB is forming a straight line. So we can say that angle formed on AOB line, angle AOB plus angle AOD, they are forming a linear pair whose sum is 180 degrees. But we already know that angle AOB is equal to angle AOD. So it comes to 90 degrees. So we can say that AC and BD or the diagonals are equal and bisect each other at right angles. Just do step by step, sequence by sequence. You will be able to prove all the things very easily. Question number 5. Show that if the diagonals of a quadrilateral are equal and bisect each other at right angles, then it is a square. So first of all, let us write down what is given to us. We are given, now this question is totally the opposite of question number 4. What we have proved in question number 4, that is given to us now. What was given in question number 4, that we have to prove it now. So let's write down one by one. Number 1, diagonals are equal. Number 2, they are bisecting each other and they bisect each other at right angles, that is 90 degrees. We need to prove that ABCD is a square. For a square, what do we want? All the sides should be equal. It should be a parallelogram and all the angles formed A, B, C or D, that should be 90 degrees. Let's begin with the first part. Take the two adjacent triangles AOD and triangle AOB. Now here we already know that angle AOD is equal to angle AOB, that is 90 degrees. It's given to us. AO is equal to OA, that is also common. And OD is equal to OB, diagonals bisect each other, that is also given to us. So by this criteria, we can say that triangles are congruent. And when the triangles are congruent, we can say that AD is equal to AB by CPCT. Similarly, we can say all the other sides are also equal and hence we can get that AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to DA. So quadrilateral ABCD have all the sides equal. Number two, we will prove that it is a parallelogram. For that, triangle AOD and triangle COB, we will take two opposite triangles. We already have AO is equal to CO and OD is equal to OB, which is given to us because diagonals bisect each other. Another is angle AOD is equal to angle COB, which is vertically opposite angles. So by using the criteria of SAS, triangles are congruent. And when they are congruent, we can say that angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Now these angle 1 and angle 2, they form the alternate interior angles. So we can say that AD is parallel to BC. Similarly, we can say that AB is parallel to DC. So whole ABCD becomes a parallelogram. Third criteria which we need to prove it, that we will be proving angle DAB, ABC or all the angles ABCD as 90 degrees for forming a square. Let's take the two big triangles ABC and triangle BAD. AC is equal to BD, it's given to us. BC is equal to AD, which we have proved above. And AB is equal to BA, that is common. So with this, we can say that triangles are congruent by SSS criteria. And thus we can say that angle ABC will be equal to angle BAD. So we will use the parallelogram property over here. What is it? AD is parallel to BC, we know that. And AB is transversal. And these two angles are on those line. So we can say that angle ABC plus angle BAD, they are equal to 180 degrees. They are co-interior angles. So we know the property of parallelogram. Thus, since both the angles are equal, we can say that they are 90 degrees. And since ABCD is a parallelogram with all the sides equal and angles 90 degrees, we can say that ABCD is a square. Question number 6. Diagonals AC of a parallelogram ABCD bisects angle A. Show that it bisects angle C also. So it is given to us that ABCD is a parallelogram and AC bisects angle A, which means angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Now here let's take AB parallel to DC and AC as a transversal. In that case, you have angle 1 equal to angle 3. They are forming alternate interior angles. Similarly, if I take AD parallel to BC and AC as a transversal, it means angle 2 is equal to angle 4. They are also alternate interior angles. Now, if you look at both the equation 1 and equation 2, we get angle 1 is equal to angle 2, which is given to us. Now, considering all the 3, 1, 2 and 3, if you see, you have angle 3 is equal to angle 4 and we can say that AC bisects angle C. Now in triangle ABC, if you see, we have angle 1 is equal to angle 4 from equation 2 and 3. So we can say that the sides will be also equal because of the isosceles property. We can say that BC is equal to AB. Similarly, if we take triangle ADC, we can say that AD is equal to DC. And ABCD is already a parallelogram. We know that AB will be equal to DC. So considering all the equations, we can say that all the sides are equal and hence ABCD is a rhombus. Question number 7. Now ABCD is a rhombus given to you and we need to prove that the diagonal AC bisects angle A as well as angle C and diagonal BD bisects angle B as well as angle D. So let's begin with the triangle ABC. I have numbered as 1, 2, 3 for the angles, so we will focus there. In triangle ABC, we know that AB is equal to BC, sides are equal, so that means angles near to them are also equal. So that is angle 3 and angle 4 are also equal. We know the isosceles property, angles opposite to equal sides of a triangle are equal. Now considering AD parallel to BC and AC as their transversal, we can say that angle 1 is equal to angle 3 as they form alternate interior angles. From equation 1 and 2, we can get angle 1 is equal to angle 4. What does it mean? That AC bisects angle A. Similarly, if we take AB parallel to DC and AC as transversal, we know that angle 2 is equal to angle 4. They are forming alternate interior angles. And again, equating equation 1 and 4, we see that angle 2 is equal to angle 3, which means AC bisects angle C. So from both the points, we can say that AC bisects angle C as well as angle A. In the same way, we can write similarly, we can prove BD bisects angle B as well as angle D. Question number 8. ABCD is a rectangle where diagonal AC bisects angle A as well as angle C. So we can write down in the given section that angle 1 is equal to angle 4 and angle 2 is equal to angle 3. It is already given to us, and we need to prove that ABCD is a square. But we already know that ABCD is a rectangle, so it means it is a parallelogram also. So we can say that AD parallel to BC and AC as transversal, in that case angle 1 is equal to angle 3. They are forming alternate angles. But we already know that angle 1 is equal to angle 4. So from equation 1 and 2, we can easily get as angle 3 is equal to angle 4. When the angles are equal, we know that the side opposite to equal angles of a triangle are also equal, which means AB is equal to BC. So what does it mean? ABCD is a rectangle whose adjacent sides are equal. So we can say that ABCD is a square. Since it is a square and diagonals of a square bisects the opposite angles, we can say that BD bisects angle B as well as angle D. In a parallelogram ABCD, P and Q are the points on the diagonal BD such that DP is equal to BQ. Let's prove the following points. We need to prove first the triangle APD congruent to triangle CQB. Let's see that. Now here we already have AD parallel to BC and BD as a transversal. So we can say that angle ADB will be equal to angle CBD. That means they are forming alternate interior angles. So let us take the two triangles and try to make them congruent. Now here AD will be equal to CB because opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. We know that PD is equal to QB, which is given to us already. And we know that angles are alternate. That is ADP and angle CBQ. They are alternate interior angles, which we have just told above. So with this we can say that both the triangles are congruent. And with this property we can also say that AP is equal to CQ by CPCT. So we have proved the second point also here. Let's see the third part, where we need to now prove the two triangles congruent, the green part. Let's begin with it. Again, we are using the alternate property over here. That means angle ABQ will be equal to angle CDP because they are forming alternate angles. The lines are parallel. Now here let's take the two triangles. QB is equal to PD, which is already given to us. Angle ABQ is equal to angle CDP, which is proved. And AB is equal to CD. Opposite sides of the parallelogram are equal. So by SAS criteria we can say that triangles are congruent. And by this CPCT we can say AQ is equal to CP. Since the opposite pair of APCQ is equal, we can say that APCQ is a parallelogram. Question number 10. ABCD is a parallelogram and AP and CQ are perpendiculars from vertices A and C on the diagonal BD. Show that triangle APB is congruent to triangle CQD. The green part which I am showing you, we will focus over there. So let's take these two triangles, and we are told that angle APB is equal to angle CQD, which is already 90 degrees. AB is equal to CD, that will be also equal because opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. And we can also say that angle ABP is equal to angle CDQ. They are forming alternate interior angles of the parallelogram ABCD, taking DB as their transversal. So both the triangles are congruent, and with that we can say that AP is equal to CQ by CPCT, as they are the parts of the congruent triangle. Question number 11. Now here you are given two triangles ABC and DEF, and you are told that AB is equal to DE, AB is parallel to DE, BC is equal to EF and BC is parallel to EF respectively, and we need to prove all the other criteria. Let's begin with one by one. What we will do is we are going to join AD, CF and BE respectively. Now to prove, first of all, A, B, E, D, a parallelogram. The red lines, if you see, we will focus there. In this, we are already told that AB is equal to DE and AB is parallel to DE. So we can say that since one pair of the quadrilateral is equal and parallel, we can say that A, B, E, D is a parallelogram. Similarly, if we take the quadrilateral B, E, C, F, if you see the blue lines, only that. We are already told BC is equal to EF and BC is parallel to EF. Since one pair is of the quadrilateral is equal and parallel, we can say that BEFC is a parallelogram. Number 3. To prove AD parallel to CF and AD equal to CF. Now what here we are going to do? We have just proved above, if you see ABED a parallelogram in point 1, which already says that AD is parallel to BE and AD is equal to BE. Similarly, in parallelogram BEFC, we have proved that BE is parallel to CF and BE is equal to CF because the opposite sides of the parallelogram are equal. So from the equation 1 and 2, we get AD parallel to CF and AD equal to CF. The fourth part. Now since AD is parallel to CF and AD is equal to CF, we can say that the sides opposite are parallel and equal. So the quadrilateral ACFD is also a parallelogram. And by since it is a parallelogram, we can say AC is equal to DF. Now in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, if you see both the triangles, we already have AB is equal to DE, which is given to us, BC is equal to EF, that is also given to us, and AC is equal to DF, which we have proved in just part number 5. So with this, by SSS criteria, we can say that the triangles are congruent. Question number 12. Now here ABCD is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to CD and AD is equal to BC. Now here you need to prove that angle A is equal to angle B and angle C is equal to angle D, and similarly all the other things. Now what we have to do is we have drawn a construction in such a way that AB line we have extended till E and we have drawn CE parallel to AB. Now what we have to do is, first of criteria is we need to prove angle A is equal to angle B. Now what we will do is, in this trapezium ABCD, if we talk about, AB is parallel to CD and AD is equal to BC, which is given to us, and CE is parallel to AD. We have just done the construction. So we can say that AECD is a parallelogram. So where we can say AD is equal to CE, opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal, but we know that AD is equal to BC. So with this criteria, equation 1 and equation 2, we can also say that BC is equal to CE of that triangle. If you look, BEC, BC is equal to EC. Now in triangle BCE, if you see, your BC is equal to CE, therefore we can say that angle 2 is equal to angle 4, because angles opposite to equal sides of a triangle are equal. Now, if you look into only angle B, it is made up of 1 and 2. So, angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degrees, that is linear pair. And angle 3 plus angle 4 will also be equal to 180 degrees because AECD is a parallelogram and we know that co-interior angles of a parallelogram, the sum will be equal to 180 degrees. So, if we see equation 4 and equation 5, equate them, we can say angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to angle 3 plus angle 4. But we already know that angle 1 is equal to angle 3. How it happened? Angle 4 is equal to angle 2. Therefore, angle A is equal to angle B. Next is we need to prove angle C is equal to angle D. Now, AB is parallel to CD and AD as transversal if you take, which means that angle 3 plus angle 5 will be equal to 180 degrees co-interior angles. Similarly, angle 1 plus angle 6 will also be equal to 180 degrees. So, if we add now equation 7 and equation 8, we get angle 3 plus angle 5 is equal to angle 1 plus angle 6, which means angle 5 is also equal to angle 6 because we have just proved that angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Now, this means angle C is equal to angle D. Now, at last we need to prove that our triangles are congruent. So, we will look into the green part, shaded part. Take the two triangles ABC and triangle BAD. Now, here AB is equal to BA, which is common. BC is equal to AD, that is given to us. And angle 1 is equal to angle 3, we have proved above. So, by SAS criteria, triangles are congruent. And when the triangles are congruent, we can at last say that AC is equal to BD because they are the parts of the congruent triangles. With this, we finish exercise 8.1, children. It was a very long exercise. Don't worry. Just focus on the concepts. What all is needed in the question. Mark it, label it. If you are facing any problem in solving it, what like I have shaded those triangles or parts so that I can concentrate only on those parts. You can also do it in the same way. Very soon I am going to come with exercise 8.2. Till then, see you children. Goodbye. Take care.